Hey everyone, my name is Will Valida. I'm a software engineer and cloud architect, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can configure HTTP ingress in your Azure Container Apps. Now, Azure Container Apps allows you to expose your container app to the public web, your virtual network, and other container apps within your environment by enabling ingress. The ingress settings are enforced through a set of rules that essentially control the routing of internal and external traffic to your container app. When you enable ingress, you don't need to create any resources like an Azure Load Balancer, public IP address, or any other Azure resources to enable incoming HTTP requests or even TCP traffic. Now, when we enable ingress, we have the choice between two types of ingress: external ingress, which accepts traffic from both the public internet and your container app's internal environment, and then internal ingress, which only allows internal access from within your container app environment. Each container app within your environment can be configured with different ingress settings. So I've got an example here. I've got a UI application which accepts HTTP ingress from the public internet as well as the environment. So I've got a user making HTTP requests to this web interface. And then I've got a container app here for my API that is accepting HTTP traffic from inside my container app environment. And you can imagine with multiple microservices, or if you've got multiple container apps inside your environment, you could have another container app here that kind of accepts traffic only from within the container app environment. Let's get that going. Come on, draw.io. Fantastic. There we go. So traffic can only be accepted. Traffic can only be accepted from within the container app environment, so no one can reach it from the outside. But in this situation, what I've got, I have a existing application which kind of accepts HTTP traffic for this API from outside my container app environment. So what I want to do in this video is essentially switch that off so no one from the outside can actually access my API application from outside the public internet. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to pop into Azure. Here I am in the Azure portal, and I'll go into my API application. And as you can see here, once it loads up, I've got an application URL. So I can open that up. And if I actually go to the right endpoint, I've got an API that essentially just returns a list of wait records. So got wait ID, measurement date, BMI, et cetera, and that's available from the public internet. And I've also got a UI application. So if I go into that container app there, and just click on that, and there we go. So there's a simple UI application that's making a call out to this API and then listing that in a nice HTML table. However, we might have situations where we have APIs that we don't necessarily want to expose to the public internet. So essentially what I want to do here is disable that. So if I go into Visual Studio Code, and if I go into my Bicep files for the backend API, just get a little bit of real estate going here. I can see that within this container app definition, I've got external traffic set to true. So if I want to limit public, or if I want to stop public access for this container app and only have communication from within my container app environment, I need to set that to false. I'm still making it available via HTTP. I'm still exposing on port 8080. But now what I should do when I deploy this container app, we should be able to see this, that this container app will not be available from outside the public internet. And also within my Bicep file, I've got a output defined for my fully qualified domain name for this container app. So if I go into my front end application at the moment, that is being consumed via an environment variable. So just this environment variable backend API, that's pointing to my current backend fully qualified domain name. So if I go back into the Azure portal and I go into my container, look at my environment settings, I should see there's the fully qualified domain name for my backend API. So I'll go back into Visual Studio and I'll just commit this. Git commit, disabling public ingress. Sign my commit. Well, it's a new branch, so if I push that, it's going to tell me, yep, to set the upstream. Oh, no. What was that? That was fun. I'm not sure what happened there. Push that to the upstream. Awesome. So now if I go back into GitHub, I should be able to create a pull request. I'll go ahead and create that pull request. That will hopefully be able to be merged into main. Yep, everything's fine. I'll confirm that merge. Then go back into code. Cool, so if I jump into GitHub Actions, that's gonna go ahead and run my GitHub action. So I'll let that run, and once that's deployed, we'll come back and we'll see what that change has done to my container app. Cool, so as you can see, everything looks like it's been deployed successfully, which is good. So now what I wanna do is go back into the Azure portal. And specifically what I'm looking at here is the URL for my API. So it's changed ever so slightly. So now I've got this internal keyword in here. So if I look at a previous version, that internal word inside my fully qualified domain name wasn't there. So this revision, because I'm running my container app with multiple revisions, if I actually go into revisions and replicas, I should hopefully see, yep. So all of these different revisions here. This is the revision that remained public. So now if I go back and try and hit this endpoint directly, I should be denied. So what I've attempted to do there from the public internet, I've attempted to access this container app, but I've disabled ingress on this container app, so I'm not able to do so. However, what I should be able to do, if I go back into my resource group, go into the UI, I will double check. See the URL there for our UI application hasn't been affected whatsoever. If I look at my revisions and replicas, everything should be okay, which is good. So now, one thing I will just check is the environment variables. If I go into containers, check out environment variables. And see which revision am I running? So VM AZGDU. So if I go into my containers based on revisions, I should see the environment variable has been changed to this internal one here, which is handy. Fantastic. So if I go back and actually hit this endpoint, I can see that the results still appear up in the table from the API. So even though the API is not publicly accessible, so if I try and hit the API directly, it's gonna deny me. The container app can still talk to our container app for our API. So our UI can still talk to our API because traffic is being redirected from within the container app environment. So for that API, we've just disabled it from the outside, giving it a bit of protection. Now, when it comes to ingress, there are other things that we can do to kind of protect our container apps. We can configure IP restrictions, client certificates, We can do some traffic splitting, some blue-green deployments, stuff like that. But this was just a very basic scenario of disabling HTTP ingress to deny access to our container app from outside of our container app environment and limit it to traffic just with inside this container app environment. If you like this video, give it a like. That's where I'm going to wrap it up for today. If you want to see more videos on Azure Container Apps, don't forget to subscribe. The code for this session, it will be in the description below, which is on my GitHub. So please check that out and see how I'm doing GitHub actions and how I'm actually structuring my Bicep files for all my Azure Container App resources. No matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day, and we'll see you all next time.